Let's create the columns of the ground floor. So we're going to run the column command. We can choose one column style from this list. Since we have a column round, we will choose the round style. We can choose one specific profile. So there is a list of sizes that comes with each column style, and we will choose the other option to change to choose a different radius. We can click on this button to measure it approximately, so we can tell this is a 20 centimeters width column. And finally we will choose a middle left alignment in order to snap with the slab edge. Just notice that we have some insert mark here for the column that matches with its alignment, but we can turn it off by selecting the column and choosing the non-on option in the insert mark. We can now just copy this column all over the ground floor to create the rest of them. We could use the rectangular array option, but this will ask us for the distance among columns, which is a value that we don't know. Instead, we're going to use the array and surface option, but first we need to draw a surface. We will use the rectangular plane for that. We're going to enable the intersection or snap to draw a surface from this point to this point. We're going to turn layer off in order to find this intersection point. And now we can activate the control points of this surface just to move these two 20 centimeters downwards. And these two 10 centimeters in the left direction. Finally, we just need to move the whole rectangle also 10 centimeters in that direction. The idea is that when we create the ray on this surface, the last column is placed in that corner. Now, we can do this actually from the top viewport, turn layer off, and run the ray on surface command. We select the column, enter, base point, click enter again, and finally the surface. We need to specify 5 in one direction, 5 in the other direction, and there we go. We can now select this surface and delete it. Now we just need to go to the ground floor, check the ground floor bitmap, and just move those columns that are in the wrong place . Just copy them to create new ones. In this case we can use the mirror command, and we can select those and make copies to create new ones. This one can go over here. We can delete this one. And for those that have a rectangular profile, we can change this into wireframe. Select the column, go to properties, change it into a rectangular style that has a rectangular profile, and we just need to set the proper size. So we go to the profile, select other, and here we can measure approximately the size of this column width and column height. We can see it has nearly 20 centimeters, so we can set this value for the width and the height of the profile dimensions. We can adjust the position and style of the rest of the columns in the ground floor. Finally, we will need to adjust the height and position of each column, because all these have been created in the ground floor elevation, since we have the construction plane on the ground floor, and they should be actually placed on the zero elevation, where the exterior slab is. So, we can select these columns. I click Shift to make a multiple selection. And from the front view, we're going to move them downwards 10 centimeters. Also, we should change their height in order that they are as high as the other columns and walls. So we're going to Properties, Column, and the height, which is now defined by style, will be changed into 2.8 meters.